Good afternoon. Today in the dungeon, we're going to do a frog. It's fairly simple, but it takes some time. This is the skeleton frog. It's a very easy pattern to do. And I like it, this thing, is that the legs really move around in the water. And it's not meant to sit exactly on top of water. What it's meant to do is go down in water just below the surface, even further down, and swim. It pushes a lot of water. It makes a lot of noise and has a lot of movement with the legs. These are fish joints. What I'm going to be using are fish joints. These are large fish joints. I'm going to use four of them. I'm using flat wax nylon. This is the sharp bright green. I'm going to use bug legs for the legs or the feet and part of the legs. I'm going to use yellow, orange, and hot radioactive. And I'm also going to use Big Bopper dubbing in the frog color. I'm going to use this in place of deer hair. I'm going to put the fish joint, the large one right here. This goes up. I call this the point. I'm going to layer this. We need four of these for the legs. I want a nice base. Now I'm going to take bug legs. I'm going to take four yellow, and I'm going to take four orange, and four hot radioactive. The hot radioactive gives me a nice green as well as UV. Pretty simple pattern, and it's made for big fish. It's a two, we need to put a 2-aught hook on here when we're finished. All right, four of them. This is the orange. It's a nice deep orange. I'm going to put the ends together just like this. Go in front of the point, dead center, pull it back. I'm going to tie it right here and I want it along the side. So I'm pulling it fairly tight, going back. I want to keep a little bit of this here. It has a nice little color to it. Cut the legs. These are basically the feet. I'm going to layer this completely with thread. I cover it all up. And I'm going to go above and tie it. Nice base here. That's where I'm going to tie down. But I want it quite, I want a lot of thread there so it doesn't slip. Got it? And I'm going to use, this is Solar X. It's a fly tying UV curing glue, which I really like. I'm going to cover this whole thing, basically the whole leg, the thread, everything. Put the UV light on it. You might see, be able to see a little bit of smoke coming up. I mean, just curing. This glue says 10 seconds. I glue about 15 basically in there on one side. You can see the UV from the thread. Put on the other side a little bit of smoke, which means it's curing. And what I do with after I finish the flies like this with this type of glue is take it outside in the sun for about 5 minutes and let it sit there. Okay, I'm going to take another one, and what I want to do is take it and put it across, but I want to do it from this side out, and the next leg will be from take this in this way because I want the point pointing out when I find the legs. I'm going to put it in here, and then I'm going to finish off the leg. Alright, thread base. I'm going to take, I think I'll do this with orange. Take two of them. Tie it in right alongside. I want to go all the way back here, go up in front of the point, make a thread base there. Take this, I'm going to wrap this. This is the rest of the leg. Go right up here, in front of the point, wrap it down. Right there. Tie it off. You can save that piece for the next one. Right? We got one leg pretty much completed. I'm going to coat this as well with the glue. This is how you use this one for pike. It's a nice big frog. About 15 seconds on each side. That pretty much takes care of it. I go outside with it. So I can really, this is really, it really hardens quickly. There's one leg. I'm not going to do another leg, and I did do another leg pre-done, but this has red on it. You can see how the red looks. We're going to use these both of these legs. All right, time to put it together. This is a 2-aught Mustad 3366 hook. I like this. I have other hooks I'm going to be using as well, some new ones. It's supposed to be for bass and pike. I'm going to layer this whole shank. I want this completely layered with thread, because we have to put the wire on here to lock in the legs. Okay, all the way back here. Now we're going to put the legs on. What I'm using, this is foam, it's 3 mil. It's regular Dries foam. You can buy it basically anywhere, you know. A couple bucks, a big sheet of it. A big sheet, so it was a foot by 18 inches. Cutting a little piece, about eighth or quarter inch wide. I'm going to tie it in right here. Tie it down nice and tight. Don't worry about the bulk on the foam. Okay, next one I'm taking. This is nylon colored multi-strand stainless steel wire. It's nylon cut, it protects it. And it keeps the strands together without individual fraying. I like this. They used these on trolling streamers back east, like the Grey Ghost, Supervisor, 9-3s, things like that. We're going to use this, you know, for the basically the joint. All right, we're going to squeeze it a little bit. I'm going to put it just like this on here, and I'm going to put the foam, pull the foam over. What this does, this is your spreader. The foam is your spreader. Keeps it right there, and it spreads the legs out so they can't cross each other. This is important. Cut this. I can use this piece for the next one. Don't use a lot of foam on this. Tie it down. What I'm going to do now, I'm going to flip it over. Since I want the points of these out, this one goes on this side. I'm going to hold it. And this one goes on this side. I'm going to slide it right through the eye. Right there. You can see how it's split. Here's one already. You can see the split. See the split on there? That's what it does. It keeps those legs apart. Alright. Put them back. I want to measure this, so I want it right about there. So I'm going to cut it. Use a pair of cutters, right there. What I'm going to do next, I'm going to take some super glue. I like this one. This is called Naline, and it's a clear glue, and it's a nice little container, and this stuff really works. That's probably one of the best super glue I've ever used. Put a nice little bunch of it up here. I'm going to put it right on top. What I want to do is lock this in on top. I'm going to pull these legs back. I want to lock it right on top, all the way back. And it'll go on the sides because it gets wide here. But you want to start it up here. I'm going to take this and lock the very bunch of it up here. Because what happens is it can cut your thread, so let's cover it first. No problems later on. All the way back. Back and forth. Okay, now what we're going to do, we're going to use Big Bopper dubbing called the Frog. There's other colors we have too, and this is called the Frog dubbing, and it's made just for this. Instead of deer hair, this is old bullfrog. You can see that color. This is bullfrog, different color. This is aqua frog, has a bluish in it. This is bright frog. It has a little bit of bright green in it. This is regular. This is brown leopard frog. Has a brownish look to it with brown legs. These all have legs in them. This is leopard frog. We're going to use Big Bopper called the Frog. I got a big bag. It takes a lot, and don't be skimpy on this. I'm taking quite a bit. Like this. This is long fibered. Better over an inch long. I'm going to put this right on the side. Tie it down. Just like you're stacking deer hair, that's all we're doing, but we're stacking not deer hair, but dubbing, made for doing this. All right, got another batch over here. And if you think you don't have enough for the back, put a little bit on top, because the bottom is going to be trimmed flat. Let's pull it back, just like you do deer hair, go up, bump it. Move up a little bit and do it again. But we're not getting it just not quite as much, but close. I'm going to be trimming this. I can do deer hair. I like this color. Nice thing about this type of, instead of using deer hair, it's mottled. You can see the mottled look in it. There's greens, olive, blacks, yellows. You know, there's a nice mottled look to it. Bump it up. Let's go for another batch. And this is going to be less because we're getting near the eye. Right here. One more batch on this side. Push it back with my thumb a little bit. There. I have room to tie it off. Like this. Okay, and again I'm going to take my fly glue or my UV glue, just touch it there. If you get into the eye, what I would do right off the bat, because this hardens really quick, if you happen to do it, do that. That'll take care of it. Take my light, zap it. I want you to see something. See all the UV look, or the legs stick out of that. Look at that. That's yellow, a lot of UV there. Okay, now we're going to trim this thing. Move the vise out of the way. I'm going to do this right off the bat. I'm going to do the bottom. I want this flat. Great, that's a hook. Eye of the hook. Back. Back this way. Back on this side. I want this flat. Now I'll go back and redo it a little bit better later. Pick it up. I'm going to fluff it up. And I'm going to go from the right dead center up. I'm going to make it high, but don't go all the way because I want a collar of it. I'm going to go down the side just a little bit. Now I'm going to do so far. Okay? I'm going to go to the side, cut up. This side, cut up. I'm going to find where I want to put my collar, right here. Trim it so it's even. Then we're going to go back, trim the bottom side a little bit more. This too. See what I need on the bottom? Trim it. But I want to go slowly, roll down. It's going like a semicircle down. I don't want a flat cut. Some more, roll up. I'm going to roll down. I'm going to go in a little bit, trim it if I want it a little bit not as wide. I'm going to roll down. Roll down a little bit. Trim it here. Do I like that? Yeah, that looks pretty good. So, now you want to put the eyes. Well, you can put them on the side and put them on top. I'm going to put them halfway in between. I'm going to cut a notch out right here on this side. Go on the other side, match it up, cut another notch out. Even on the bottom. Okay, a little bit more there. There. Got my notch here and my notch here. Then I'm going to put eyes in. There's types of eyes you can use for this. These are fish eyes. These are the frog eyes. It has a frog eye pupil in there. These are the prey eyes. And it's like a frog eye pupil, but high. So you put it at every angle, like it's looking up, down, or, you know, away. These are the croc eyes. And these happen to be flat 8mm, flat yellow, glow, and black. They're glow in the dark, and then there's three different colors in there. And here's a regular 8mm gold eyes. I like yellow, flat yellow, but I use 8mm. And it's like kind of this 2-aught hook. And that's it. Now with the eyes, this is one fly. You can see the eyes on here. Sometimes I put the eyes up here, and what's in the water, it goes down, and it really moves. And these legs stand right out. They stand right out when you're pulling them through the water. So there it is. It takes a little time, but it's very simple. The most difficult thing is making the cuts. And once you do a couple of them, you get the cuts down. The skeleton frog.
I was working in the lab late one night when my eyes beheld an eerie sight, for my monster from his slab began to rise, and suddenly, to my surprise,
he did the mash.
He did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
He did the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
He did the mash.
He did the monster mash. From my laboratory in the castle east, to the master bedroom where the vampires feast, the ghouls all came from their humble abodes to get a jolt from my electrode.
They did the mash.
They did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
They did the mash.